I'll see you guys at the lift.
Boy, that was great!
Hi, folks, I'm John Denver. And this, well, this, of course, is Colorado. You know, the emotions I feel up here I've expressed many times in music and song. But you can't always carry a guitar. That's why I bring one of these. For me, this is...
Jump.
Television. Oh.
Ain't but one man alive who ain't gonna wuss out on my violent way of love. I'm gonna find you, Crow Dickerson. When I do, I'm either gonna love you as hard as a biker chick can, or I'm gonna do a wheelie on your face until you die screaming, you son of a bitch. Crow's been here. I can feel it. The whole town is littered with pregnant, abandoned teenage trash. When I'm on his trail, I can feel it. Red ants in my blood. How'd you end up in such a sorry state?
It was such a shiny bike, just like yours. He looked just like a rock and roll star. He told me he had a rough childhood, and I thought he was real sensitive.
Yeah, he had a rough childhood, all right.
Sister Frosty, this is the second motorcycle child that's been deposited here this month. Them people's like animals. Look, she ain't wearing nothing but a saddlebag. Christ, Ola!
Lisey's got more on than the little girl did when they dumped her here. She wasn't wearing nothing but a sterling silver tire chain. Ain't that right, Sister Knuckles?
For Pete's sake, get the kid indoors. He's got road rash. You watch. He's gonna be a discipline problem, just like the girl. I swear to God. Amen.
Where did he go?
He said he was looking for someone. Then he followed a crow that passed him in the sky out of town.
Get away from my bike.
Is he looking for you?
Yeah, he's looking for me. Our souls are handcuffed together. We both knew it from the get-go.
Crow over there says he wants to ride you on the back of his tricycle, so you better get over there.
Tell Crow I ride my own tricycle.
Oh, you're gonna get it. He's gonna beat on you, Winter Steel.
He's gonna stop breathing before he turns 7. Do what you want, Crow. You're gonna have to turn your back on me someday, and that's when I'll get you from behind.
That's the plug. He gives you the spark plug. That was the only thing that he ever got from his mommy and daddy. Oh, let me see it.
I'm close. His trail smells like a burning church and looks like the place where goofies go to die. Where's your powder room?
You're gonna need a key.
You gonna give it to me?
It's in my front pocket. You're gonna have to get it yourself.
Shoot, these panties ever been laundered? We put each other through every possible initiation to prove we were made to drag each other to heaven or hell. We purified our love with bloody noses and cigarette burns. When the juvenile youth authorities separated us, they didn't think a love-hate teenage relationship like ours would mean nothing to us after a little while. But they were wrong. I'm on your trail, you dumb bastard. Where the hell are you?
Thanks for letting me fix your bike, Mr. Crow, sir.
Dear ma'am, lost my virginity as per the instructions. At last I was ready for the sex change. I joined an order of military nuns and poisoned half of them.
Aha, if only the Mahoney twins were alive to see this.
Have you ever seen this man?
It's no good. I'm losing contact.
Ah, satisfaction. The deed is done. Your brother's murder is avenged. Now, a discussion of financial and amorous considerations.
Imbecile, I just heard the radio reports. You killed the wrong man.
Ah, Weasel, did you decipher the Arab's cryptic last words?
Never mind that. I just got another anonymous tip.
What do you suggest?
Murder.
Another 5 minutes and I'll be packed and out of here. Hey, what gives?
Easy, sister. I'm Inspector Payne.
What do you want, Flatfoot?
Questions answered.
But Mr. Z, all these murders. Is it right to go sightseeing while killers are loose?
Patience, my dear. I feel we are about to come full circle.
Okay, Z. Stand still while I plug you.
Sorry, that's not my style.
Mr. Z, what was that all about?
I'm not sure, my dear. But I sense that all these activities are being controlled by invisible hands reaching out of the darkness.
Stick Figure Theater.
Good afternoon. Here we have a quiet little motel.
Let's go along to cabin number one. I want to show you something there.
The bathroom. You should have seen the blood. The whole place was, well, it's too horrible to describe. Dreadful. Well, the murderer, you see, crept in here. Very slowly, of course, the shower was on, there was no sound. And,
balloon? What the hell?
Stupid sewer clowns. Public education is going down the gutter. Crap, I'm late!
You're gonna pay for that, brat! Ha! Gotcha! Looks like fast food is on the menu.
What the hell? I thought something tasted funny.
Dear Mum, the surviving sisters have come after me. Fortunately, I saw them coming and made a fast getaway. They turned my place upside down, and they're holding my precious Pierre hostage.
No sign of the perp.
Keep your eyes peeled, Nikki.
You know, that's a weird word, perp.
Perp?
Yeah, perp. It's like when you run your dishwasher and your plates are covered in gunk and you're like, these dishes are covered in perp, damn it.
Or like when you have too many beers or too many nachos the night before and you wake up in the morning and you're like, man, I've got the perps. Coffee.
What does it even mean?
Perp.
Yeah.
It's Latin.
Comes from the word papyrus. It means scumbag.
I love it when you talk smart.
You said to keep your eyes peeled.
Whoa!
It's Bergens.
You look like hell.
I'm undercover.
What's happening over there?
It's nothing.
It's just undercover. It's just some guy I've never met before in my entire life.
Will you tell that guy you've never met before that I miss him? That every time I pull out my 5.5-inch Glock and unload on some perp, thinking of him.
It's go time. Let's do this. Let's get this son of a bitch.
Lost him. And I feel really bad about shooting you in the heart, Sledge. I'm so sorry.
Don't you ever apologize for doing your job. You're a good cop, damn it.
Besides, it's really dark out there.
Where were you, Perkins? We needed you out there.
I told you.
I'm...
Undercover.
That'll be $50, hon.
You are under arrest.
Kablammo.
Salami!
Salami! Bologna!
Bologna! Great jam!
Great jam, man. That's the best part. Great jam.
Ham or turkey leg?
How about bacon and smoke deal?
No eel.
So, what do you think? Oh, I'm sorry. Let me get that for you.
You wrecked my shirt.
Oh. Under fire at the door. My hermaphroditic high, you heel. Oh, give me this.
You jerk. How am I gonna eat that sandwich?
No matter what you do, we'll be watching you on cut-up camera. Cut-up camera. It's cut-up camera. Cut-up camera.
People will do almost anything to stay in shape these days. Or will they? We thought it might be funny to find out.
Hi, my name is Linda. Are we ready to sweat?
What our little exercisers don't know is that Linda is no ordinary aerobics instructor.
Let's begin with a couple of totally cool stretches.
In fact, we found her at the circus.
Okay, now right leg first. Now both legs. Feel the stretch. Just reach over and grab those ankles. And march. Come on, you can kick higher than that.
Don't try this at home.
All right. Now, arms out. Just let your head go. Back and forth. Back and forth. Just let it roll. That's right. How's that feel?
Unfortunately, we don't have time to show you the whole workout. But let's check in and see how our exercisers feel after their first real workout.
Okay, you were excellent.
Hey, you. Smile. You're on cut-up camera.
Dear Mum. Received a hot piece of information. They were holding Pierre for ransom in an underground bunker. Brought the goods to the required location. But Pierre was never seen again.
If I was gonna eat you, I would have done it already. You've been out for hours.
But aren't you one of them? Aren't you?
A zombie? You could say that.
But you're talking to me.
Yes. That is a mystery, isn't it?
Is this where you live?
For lack of a better word, yes. More accurately, you might say this is where I spend the majority of my time. And I have lots and lots of that.
Why'd you save me from the other zombies?
Good question. You might say I have a soft spot for endangered species. More importantly, what were you doing out there all alone? How did you find this place?
I heard music.
What's your name?
Zoe.
Where did you come from?
The beach, I think. I don't remember much before I woke up.
That makes two of us. You're coming?
Where are we going?
We've got to get you to a human settlement. Somebody might be looking for you. Keep your eyes open, Cerebus.
What's the matter?
We're being watched. It's 20 miles to the nearest settlement. The entire world is teeming with bloodthirsty zombies. Would you rather walk or drive? Seatbelt. Whoops.
Where are we?
Trust me on this one. You don't want to know.
What's wrong?
It's going to be a long night.